Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. We continue with Kain Upanishad part 2. The Upanishads, a part of the Vedas, are ancient Sanskrit texts that contain some of the central philosophical concepts and ideas of Hinduism, some of which are shared with religious traditions like Buddhism and Jainism. The Upanishads are devoted to understanding the inner meaning of the religion. They explicate its crucial doctrines, rebirth, the law of karma, the means of conquering death and of achieving detachment, equilibrium and spiritual bliss. They emphasize the perennial search for true knowledge, writes Valery Roebuck, a commentator and translator of the Upanishads. Kain Upanishad is called Kain because it begins with the inquiry, by whom, willed or directed, does the mind go towards its object? From whom comes life? What enables man to speak, to hear and see? These questions are answered in part 1 of this video. The teacher in reply tells the pupils the definition of Brahman, the source and basis of existence. The spirit of the Upanishads is always to show that no matter where we look or what we see or feel in the visible world, it all proceeds from one source. Today's discussion relates to Brahmana, how to reach Brahmana, what are the essential ingredients of our activity through which we can reach Brahmana. First, a parable is told. The Brahman once won a victory for the Devas. Through that victory of the Brahman, the Devas became elated. They thought, the victory is ours. The glory is ours. Brahmaha devabhyo vijagye tasyaha brahmano vijaye deva ama hiyanta. The Brahman perceived this and appeared before them. They did not know what mysterious form it was. The devatas said to fire, O Jata Veda, you know everything. You are all knowing. Find out what mysterious spirit this is. Agni said, yes, why not? He ran towards it. And Brahman said to him, who art thou? I am Agni. I am Jata Veda. I know all the Vedas. I am very learned. Brahman asked, what power resides in thee? Agni replied, I can burn up all whatsoever exists on earth. Brahman placed a straw before him and said, burn this. Agni rushed towards it with all the speed but was not able to burn it. So he returned from there and said to the Devas, I was not able to find out what this great mystery is. The Devas said to Vayu, the god of winds, find out what this mystery is. He also went towards Brahman, asked him, who art thou? Brahman asked Vayu, who art thou? I am Vayu. I am Matrishva, traveler of heaven. Brahman said, what power is in thee? Vayu replied, I can blow away all whatsoever exists on earth. Brahman placed a straw before him and said, blow this away. Vayu rushed towards it with all the speed at its command, but was not able to blow it away. So he returned from there and said to the Devas, I'm sorry, I was not able to find out what this great mystery is. The Devas asked Indra, their king, O worshipful one, find out what this mystery is. He said, okay, I'll go and find out in a minute. Nobody can escape my scrutiny. But Brahman disappeared. Then Indra saw in that very space a woman, beautifully adorned, Uma, of golden hue, daughter of Himavati, Himalaya, and he asked her, what is this great mystery? Uma said, it is Brahman. It is through the victory of Brahman that you are victorious. The Devatas have won the war because it is Brahman who helped them. Then from her words, Indra knew that the mysterious form was Brahman. Therefore, these Devas, Agni, Vayu and Indra, excel other Devas because they came nearer the Brahman. The Rishi is telling you to come nearer the Brahman through your own effort. How? That will come now. It was they, the Devas, who first knew the spirit as Brahman. You can also know the spirit of Brahman. The teaching of Brahman is here illustrated with reference to the Devas, writes the Upanishad. He flashed like lightning and appeared and disappeared just as the eye winks. The teaching next is regarding Adhyatman, the embodied soul. The mind seems to approach him, that is Brahman, by his mind seeking again and again, remembers and thinks about Brahman. This is meditation. Think about Brahman again and again. The effort has to be made repeatedly all through your life. The Brahman is called Tadvanam, object of adoration. He is to be worshipped by the name Tadvanam. He who knows Brahman thus is loved by all beings. The disciple asked, O Master, teach me the Upanishads. The teacher replied, the Upanishads has been taught thee. We have certainly taught you the Upanishads about Brahman. The Upanishad is based on, the Guru amplified, tapas, practice of the control of body, mind and senses. Again, we are going to meditation. Dhamma, subjugation of the senses. Karma, right performance of prescribed actions. Mind you, here the Guru is relating everything to human beings, to their activity, and asking them to perform tapasya, to control themselves and to perform the right action. He says, this is Upanishad and this is the way to access Brahman. The Vedas are the limbs of Upanishad. The truth is its support, its pillars. He who knows this wisdom of the Upanishads, having been cleansed of all sin, becomes established in the blissful, eternal and highest abode of Brahman, said the Guru. May my limbs, speech, energy, eyes, ear and vitality, as well as all other senses, become more vigorous. This is a prayer at the end of TN Upanishad. All are that Brahman of the Upanishads. May I never deny Brahman, nor may Brahman deny me. Let there be no denial at all. Let there be no denial at least from me, who am devoted to Atman. It is our Atman which has to strive to reach Brahman. Om Shantih, Shantih, Shantih. So this is a step-by-step instruction to the pupil. Control your senses, sit in meditation, and you would achieve Brahman. You must do the right deeds. You must not harm anybody. You must not do any papa, evil activity. Thank you. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you for visiting this site. We shall meet again very soon with the next Upanishads.